this is my wife, Kat. And today we're going to go to the Lakeland Zombiefest.
Yep.
Which is the 5th annual Lakeland Zombiefest. It's basically like, I believe, a primarily outdoor convention with kind of like a festival type feel. This is our first time going. I don't even think we've ever been to Lakeland before.
Zombiefest 2016, everybody say hey! Alright, so who swallowed the most meat? Who won the hamburger challenge? I know somebody with your name. I'm gonna hook you up. Alright, y'all, thank you so much for having me. I'm gonna run down to Club Main Street. I want you to make sure you check us out on Facebook, Club Main Street. It's that simple. If you want to catch me, Nevitz is Steven backwards. Ooh, everybody say ooh. Everybody say ah. Everybody say gorgeous. Thank you. Oh, y'all are so sweet. Thank you so very much. One more time, Miss Freddy DeJesus.
Drop that gorgeous. Catherine Nevitz, everybody in the house. From Club Main Street, give it up. We are partying here at Zombiefest. We're so happy you're out on the lawn from the main stage with us.
Michael Rainey whistled the day the earth stood still. But he told us where we stand. And Flash Gordon was there and so blinded away. Claude Rains was the invisible man. And this is how the message ran. Silence Fisher. And Francis
truck. It's astounding. Time is fleeting. Madness takes its toll.
It's just a jump to the left. Put your hands on your hips.
Show at the Polk Theater. Give it up for the cast of the original Lipstick Players and the Rocky Horror Picture Show.
It's supposed to be midnight. Something evil's lurking in the dark. You start to breathe. Hands over the new tree right between the eyes.
Creatures crawl in search of blood to terrorize your neighborhood. But stand and face the hounds of hell and rot inside a corpse's shell.
Let's get out of here. Attendant. for taking part of this stupid idea. And apparently I'm not the only one that digs it. So thank you all for coming out. This is year number 5. And when we started out, we didn't know what we were going to do. And we've got just about 9,000 of you lunatics that are fans. So thank you all for coming out. Thanks for the input. Thanks for putting up with all the ups and downs and in-betweens and hiccups and stuff.
Pretty big turnout. Nope.
It's $1 off tacos.
Nope. Go ahead.
Zombiefest was really cool. It's our first year going, like MJ mentioned earlier, but it's definitely worth checking out. Price is really reasonable. The vendors are really awesome. Everybody was super friendly. The staff was really friendly and helpful. The event itself, as far as like the stage and everything, they've been having some sound technical difficulties. Sometimes it wasn't bad. I understand they're, you know, just starting to really learn how to cater to a larger crowd from what everybody around has told me. This is like their second year of having this particular venue. And so other than like the sound difficulties and just the awkwardness, because it wasn't exactly what I was expecting initially. Like my favorite thing so far that we've seen tonight was the Hocus Pocus show.
Yeah.
I cannot think of their name, but the person who did the Hocus Pocus show in particular, they were awesome.
Steven.
Yeah, there we go.
Nevitz.
Yeah. Steven backwards, which that was really cute. That was awesome. It was just fun. I was very uncomfortable when we initially were driving up here just because
I basically drove into redneck hell. There was a bunch of like vote for Trump signs on the way in and a bunch of obnoxious white people wearing Confederate flag shirts and stuff. And the second I see people like that, I'm automatically like, this is not my space. I don't belong here. I grew up in that type of environment, so I know what it's like. I'm not talking out of my ass.
I have the same background as that to a degree.
Yeah.
So I understand.
You're from Mississippi. You have it more than me.
But my family wasn't really entrenched in that so much because my grandparents that raised me were from Kansas originally. Anyway, after the Hocus Pocus show and then really getting to hear the hosts and everybody talk and what a majority of the entertainment and like where they're from, I got more comfortable.
Yeah. What she's trying to say is we were super uncomfortable until the gays took the stage and the Rocky Horror Picture Show started and everything else, and we're like, okay, we're safe. Well, especially after the things that have happened this year, I'm still very cautious in certain environments.
Anyway, I've always wanted to get my face painted. Usually I wouldn't do it because we're always at the theme park, or I'm too shy to go up there and be like, hey, I'm 28, will you paint my face, make it look spooky? But it's a money thing, because it's just like, do I really want to pay, you know, like $8 or whatever for something that I'm going to wash off at the end of the night? It was worth it. Like, it stuck to me. The slime. It was supposed to just be a regular skull face, but then I told her to Beetlejuice it up because I love Beetlejuice, so she put some green in there, and I think it came out really cool.
Yeah.
I wish that we had done more of the booths. Like, I feel bad that we didn't film more of the booths, so.
It got very congested, though, in certain parts walking around there, and a lot of the booths are very small, so they have some really cool stuff, but it's very much like a one or two item specialty thing. Your mohawk looks really cool. Turn your head. Look at that. That's all me. That's all me. I am a hair genius.
I have lemonade in my mouth.
Well, what else would be in that lemonade cup?
It's been fun. So I definitely would come back again next year.
Stage is way up there. We have vendors all the way around. we're gonna head out this way towards the parking lot.
It's open until I think midnight, but I'm pretty exhausted and we have an hour and a half to drive home.
And so back in the back here behind the vendors, they had jump houses and climbing stuff. And there is the scare house stuff. But we are not doing that tonight. Not doing that tonight because I am a coward.
No.
This is the future, ladies and gentlemen.
I need one.
A rock and a fall from above.
I need one. I would drive that to work in a heartbeat. Do you know how easy it would be to get down I-4 in that thing?
That's pretty great. It's pretty cool, all of the inflatable stuff for the kids. And I walked in a ditch.
Don't do that.
There, sorry. That looks like fun, but I would never do it. They have this awesome RV where they've got a projection in the window. This is where we came in earlier. They had metal detector swiping and stuff, which I appreciated. So it's after 9 and there's a pretty big line to get in.
There's an after party thing too.
That's awesome.
Yeah. So we're on our hour and a half drive home now. Getting out was a lot easier than getting in just because the parking attendants, they had a lot more of them and they seemed to have a better idea of what they were doing than when we first came in. I don't know what we're up to next weekend yet. Regardless, we always update on Thursdays. If you guys enjoyed this video, you should hit the like button. In fact, you should hit the like button for the adorable little thriller babies because they were cute. And if you want to continue to come on our adventures with us, you should subscribe. We still do not know how to end these videos.
Okay, bye.
I guess we could just walk through.
I don't know if you can see the moon, but it looks so cool. Let me zoom in on it. Oh! Stupid clouds.
Ah! No!
It's like screaming. It's a zombie fest.